you get off the ferry, it's amazing. The rest of the world kind of just dissipates. For a lot of people, that's what they're looking for when they come to Martha's Vineyard.
The beaches here up island are some of the most spectacular places you can imagine. You have to hike sometimes, and you come through a clearing, and you're upon some of the most beautiful places you've ever seen.
The outdoor world is fabulous, going kayaking or just walking on the beach. There's a lot of fabulous restaurants and businesses to shop at.
We have 5 towns here, and each town is so unique in and of itself. There's the whaling history of Egertown, but then there's the cottage and the campgrounds in Oak Bluffs.
I mean, I hate to use the word utopia, but it is. It's beautiful. It's natural beauty.
It's been an operational airfield since the late 20s. There's always been some sort of beach snack shack here. And we've been a diner here for the past 10 years.
White Fork Diner is a favorite of mine and also my kids. We go there for lunch. We sit out on the deck, watch the planes come in.
It's like we're a little mini amusement park, and I think that's why so many families and children come here and they get to eat some great food.
The Port Hunter's named after a cargo ship that sunk out here off of Martha's Vineyard. It was always a great fishing destination that we fished at. We're very fortunate with the seafood that we get here on Martha's Vineyard. Our oysters get dropped off by oyster farmers. They don't come off of a truck. We have docks right here that we get fish before fancy restaurants in New York.
Lois has been on Martha's Vineyard for 22 years. My background was always Southern cooking, and I decided to do a Cajun Creole twist on the Southern style seafood that I really loved. Jambalaya is, of course, a signature dish, but I'm using all New England seafood, so it makes it a little different. We're using scallops from New Bedford. We're using clams from the pond next door. You feel like you're home. Everyone says, you really had a good time at the party. Like, they felt like they were coming to my house.
This has been a tourist attraction since the 1860s when it was first lit. But the advancing erosion left us to within almost 40 feet of the edge. We had to transport it 130 feet inland to a position where we should be guaranteed at least 150 more years.
Gayhead Lighthouse is one of the best places on island to visit because you go up there and you see this beautiful structure that's a functioning lighthouse, and then you get to walk around the corner and look over those cliffs, and it's just spectacular.
Originally, tent people came for longer and longer periods of time, and the longer you're in a tent, the more you don't like it. So they morphed after the Civil War into these little gingerbread cottages.
To see the gingerbread cottages that people always see in the postcards, it's idyllic. It's like walking through a fairy tale.
Most of what's in this building right now was gathered from other cottages, and it still goes on today. Somebody's liable to walk in right now and say, look what I found in my cottage.
Island alpaca is a special place because it hosts alpacas. They're so soft and mild-mannered, and they're so gentle. They have beautiful fleece that is soft as cashmere. It's many times warmer than wool, and it's hypoallergenic, so it makes beautiful product. It's a great family activity. They can come and just visit us and meet and greet the alpacas here in the viewing area, and the kids can pet them and enjoy the alpacas up close.
Offshore Ale was built in 1997. It has been a fully operational restaurant and brewery serving the island 365 days a year since that time. Favorite beers at Offshore would be an India Pale Ale called the Lazy Frog, very, very popular. We also have a Belgian IPA that we do called Hop Goddess, and we have an easy drinking style beer. It's a golden ale called East Chop Lighthouse Golden. We're very family friendly. We have the peanut shells on the floor. All the kids love that. It's definitely a fun spot to either have lunch or dinner or just somewhere in the time here on the island. Just come and join us.
The most unique thing about 20 by 9 is that we have one of the most comprehensive American whiskey lists in all of New England, which is kind of fun because here we are on this rock out here in the middle of the Atlantic. We do everything from scratch, so everything gets built from like the simplest ingredient all the way up to a beautiful cocktail or a really great dinner. We try and embrace some really elegant things like our dining, but at the same time, we wanted to have like a really comfortable rock and roll kind of feel to the place, you know?
The Ritz is probably the most iconic dive live bar on Martha's Vineyard, maybe in New England. And it has always been kind of the year-round hangout for both fishermen, locals, and then in the summertime, of course, tourists.
When you are on the island and you want to hear great music, you come into the Ritz. The amount of talent on this little island is amazing, and they're always here.
You have this incredible island that we live on. The natural beauty of the island is part of what I think draws all of us in. And then what keeps us in is this incredible community of like-minded artists and real people.